Hi, Rich Carlton here. In this video, we're doing a live in-person demo with Nick. And Nick is essentially the visual designer behind the latest versions of Starting Point. And so he wants to cover some of the techniques about thinking WebDirect. So with that, I'm going to hand this off to him.
So we have two ways to think WebDirect, right? The first way is we have layouts that you can access with FileMaker Pro Client. We build with the right design and the right architecture. And one of the best way you can learn and discover the best way to design layout for WebDirect is to see what we did for FM Starting Point. All the layout in FM Starting Point are built to be WebDirect compliant. So you have, this is the way you can design things for WebDirect. And you can see here, we don't have any problem of loading data and stuff like that. It's very fast. When you click, the refresh is fast, the navigation's fast. Why? It's because we use a very straightforward design, very flat design. We don't have complex buttons and we don't have complex objects. We don't have object pile up on top of each other. We don't have complex things that are not necessary. We go straight to the point. So this is the first way you can think WebDirect. You have a layout for Pro, and when you build your layout for Pro, you had WebDirect in mind. And the result is you have a very full accessible layout for on WebDirect. Now, this is the first way we can think about this stuff. This is the other way to design for WebDirect. It's for a different audience, so the look and feel of the layout will be different because it's a public access of a layout. When I say public, it's a controlled public, meaning the company using this has customer, limited number of customer, like let's say 10 or 15 customers, and they give access to their profiled people, and they have a password, login and password. So I'm going to log in. So this is a login page made out of FileMaker. When you have customer like that, you know, you don't want to use the FileMaker login thing. You have your own login, but this is what you want. So I'm going to log in. So I'm saying in, and this is WebDirect. So we are here in WebDirect. So I have multiple records here, right? So, and as you can see, I'm navigating through records directly from here. The server is not on premise. It's somewhere in near New York. Okay. So, you can see I have no problem of loading. I don't have a reflow of data. You know, I don't have the reflow of the layout. And I said earlier, I'm not leaving this layout to do things. For example, here I have three different panels here. I have the project, the investment, and the strengths and risks. As you can see, they look like tabs. Actually, they are slide control and stuff. But I know we have a lot of videos talking about that. And then here, for example, in project, I have different kind of tab we call accordion tabs. So we also have videos talking about how to create accordion tabs. And you can download our Red Downtown sample file as well, where we demonstrate how to create those kind of tabs we call accordion. So those accordion tabs are very good. And you can see here, I have charts, I have text, and I have different kind of presentation. I even have a website access directly from here. So I click here. Oh, I have a blocker here, but it's okay. You got the point. And I have a tab here with different kind of information here. And I have another tab here with this kind of information here, right? And you have another tab here. So you can see we have multiple tabs inside the layout, but you don't feel that you are in a nested tab environment, you know, in a nested tab design. You don't feel that at all because the way they look and the way they behave, some are horizontal, some are vertical, like this one and this one, horizontal, vertical. So you combine both axes, X and Y, so you don't feel nested tabs. Actually, it was kind of impossible to get this number of tabs with those long names when you have a horizontal tab control. It's not possible. So you can see here you have a lot of information in the same layout. And you have other cool thing, like you can even here you can take pictures and put your pictures and stuff like that here. And of course you reload the pictures each time you change the record, right? And here you have a cool feature. You have your own discussion chat system inside FileMaker with WebDirect. So you say, hello, how are you? And you send this and the person receiving the message actually receive an email saying that, hey, you have a message. The server sent an email. And then the other person, the agent of this guy, when he logs in FileMaker, he sees the message and he can answer in the flow, right? In the thread. So you create your own thread, inside FileMaker, you have your own discussion, your own chat system in FileMaker. Very easy to do. So pretty much if you want to build something like that with PHP, it takes a lot of resource and a lot of money to do that when it's very, very simple to build that with FileMaker. As I said earlier in the video, the design is light. I have a lot of information. With a lot of information, related information, those are related information. This is related information, all those related information in this as well. So you can use the relationship instead of going to another layout. And then you don't have the feeling of this reflow of, you know, when you go to another layout, you have this feeling of reflowing everything, you know, reloading everything. You don't have this feeling here. You can just, you know, navigate through records and navigate through information here and here and here. And then you can expand that much wider if you need. Richard said it's snappy. Something else that I recommend is to use the FileMaker product documentation that you can find very easily Googling FileMaker documentation, and you click the first results. You go here, you click the FileMaker server 16, which will be 17 soon, and you download the FileMaker 16 WebDirect guide here. And you will have a lot of information of different of behavior, and you know, understanding the capabilities and the optimizing the performance, and you can have, you know, technique and more information. But pretty much what I've been covering in this interview with Rick Carlton is things that we know will work very well in your succeeding of implementation of WebDirect solution, and you can rely on that documentation as well. And so this is it.